always ready for action. Nip it in the bud, we never relaxing. Outcast is everlasting, not clashing, not at all. But see, my went to do a little acting. Now that's for anyone asking. Give me one and pass them. Drip, drip, drop, there goes an orgasm. Now you coming out the side of your face, we tapping right into your memory bank. Thanks. So click of the ticket, let's see your seatbelt fasten. Trunk rattling like 2 minutes in the back seat wrestling. Speaker box vibrate the tag, make it sound like aluminum cans in a bag. But I know y'all wanted that 808, can you feel that BASS bass? But I know y'all wanted that 808, can you feel that BASS bass?
I like the way you move.
In the beginning of the first half and the beginning of the second half, I thought we did a really nice job of creating opportunities for our shooters and for our bigs. I think our bigs really came through in the second half where we needed to. And obviously, Kelly and Michelle had wonderful games, just being very efficient on the floor, at both ends of the floor, with rebounding and with making shots.
Kelly, as Coach kind of alluded to, executing well in the first half with the ball movement. How much easier does that make the game for you when you're getting situations like that?
It makes it a lot easier. You know, when we're playing together and we're connecting, the ball's moving and it's just easier to score, easier to play.
And defensively, I mean, with the block shots and like, how important is that for you?
That's something I take pride in. You know, all the time I can't score, so I think that's something I could do all the time, and I take pride in that.
Michelle, as the game was going on, defensively you were holding them down in the first half. The second half they started to score a little bit more, yet you never let them get out on the run. So importance, can you talk about the importance of that on the offensive end and to keep scoring in a situation where you're kind of way ahead?
Yeah, like Coach was saying in the locker room, we did a lot of high-low, and that was working for us today. So even though sometimes when they were scoring on us, we were scoring back today. I don't like getting scored on, but it was nice that we were scoring too.
How about the overall defensive effort? What was your opinion, the way the assessment of the way the Hawks played on D?
Well, I love when we play well on defense, and I feel like every time we talk and communicate and work together as one, we play really good defense.
Coach, in that first half, is it about as well as you think you can execute? You know, everything, the way everything was going.
I think we could have made more 3-point shots. That would have been better. You know, I think we were in the first half. We were 2 for 11. So. You know, if you go by the percentages, we're shooting about 35-38%. So two more of those, I think that would be almost the perfect half, you know. So, you know, us coaches, we always want more, right? Never satisfied. But, you know, I thought our bigs really just came in strong. And I think, you know, bigger making shots, you know, just in those gray areas against the zone, against the man that are hard to cover. So that was really, really great for us today.
But if the threes aren't going, you could lean on the inside game to that.
Yeah, I mean, that's the nature of the game. You can't live and die by the three. We don't. You know, we have the ability to go inside, and that's, you know, that's something that we want to exploit every time that we're out on the court. Be hard to guard.
And that second half start, is that important for you to say you didn't want Rhode Island to get the idea they can hang around and get back into it?
Absolutely. You know, I think that's to really come out and really give the first punch in both halves just to set the tone. And we did that. You know, I think we made our first couple shots and got some stops. So